Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope everyone is good. Hope you guys are having a good one and hope you guys are staying safe. So yes, and I hope you guys have followed my medical journey and yeah, medical school is done and man is a doctor now, working as an intern in Tanzania, and it has been a long ride. And currently this is my first month as a doctor. And I'm going to give you guys a little experience check of how I experienced my first month as a doctor. And during my first month as a doctor, I started in the pediatrics department. So basically I was working with children, of which I started with pediatrics because it's departments that I don't really like that much. So I decided that, okay, I'm going to start with pediatrics. So my first month as a doctor, I was in pediatrics, working with all the pediatricians, the registrars, the nurses assistants, and so forth. And as a doctor, one of the challenges that I've actually come across as an intern doctor is that, guys, it's hard. Woo! Okay, it is hard. It gets really, really hard. And I'm gonna divide this video into two parts. The hard things about internship and the good things about internship in the past month that I've been. So one of the first good things about internship is that you're actually practicing everything, and I mean literally everything that you've learned from school. Some of the things that you actually forgot from school, they start coming back and you're like, oh, okay, okay. Especially when the specialist is explaining, or someone of a higher position than you is explaining, another doctor is explaining, you're like, okay, It starts making sense, like everything you studied starts making sense. Things actually do make sense. So you actually get to practice everything that you've learned in medical school, all the theory stuff that you've practiced, or all the knowledge that you've gathered that's way, way behind you, like it starts piecing together, it starts making sense, and you sit like, okay, I see this, okay, it makes sense. You start making sense of almost everything that you've learned in medical school. All those boring lectures, they start making sense. All those lectures that you didn't miss, they actually start making sense. So that's one of the best things about being an intern and working as a doctor. You get to practice everything that has been preached to you throughout your medical school. Another thing that's nice about being an intern is that you get to finally use your title. You get to say, hello, I'm Dr. PADIMA. Hello, I'm this and this. You don't have to always say, hello, I'm a medical student, I'm here to take your blood, I hope it's okay. Then the relatives or the patient will be coming and saying, can I speak to the doctor, because you're not the doctor. Then sometimes that can actually decrease your morale. But as a intern doctor, you can actually say, hello, I'm Dr. PADIMA, hello, I'm Dr. this, I'm Dr. that, and I am here to help you. How can I assist you? How can I be of help? And then if you don't know something, you can still go and consult your senior and get more help. Of which I feel like it's one of the nice things about being an intern doctor, or rather a doctor with a title. And also one of the nice things about being a doctor or an intern doctor, is the fact that you actually get to work in a team. It's not a one-man show. As much as you are allowed to make decisions, you are also allowed to help, to ask for help. You work in a team. For example, I'm in pediatrics and we're working as a team. We have the specialist, we have a registrar, we have the intern doctor, which is me, and we have a nurse, a nursing assistant, and we all work as a team. Sometimes you find that the nurse has more experience than you, and when they have more experience than you, it's okay to say, okay, I know it from this theoretical part of view, you know, from a practical point of view, find a mutual ground of understanding and work together. That's one of the nice things about being an intern and working as a team. Another thing about working as an intern is the fact that this is the part where you actually explore parts of your life that you don't really understand. Like, you are moving from either being a student to being an adult. That transition of life is almost interesting because you are an adult now, you have a lot of responsibilities, and for me it's fun because I get to grow as a person. For some people it might not be, but for me it is fun. So it's one of the positive things about the internship. So now let's go to the not so good. I won't say the negative, but they're not so good. First, the working hours. The working hours of interns can be tedious, they can be hectic. And you're an intern, my friend. You are bottom of the ocean. You are the guy that when everyone comes to the ward, they need to talk to. When everyone comes to the ward, the guy that has to know everything. So it has a lot of work. You're the guy that takes the samples, you're the guy that makes the orders, that writes the notes, you're the guy that literally does almost everything. You are the guy in the team that when they need results, they look at you. When they need an update on the patient, they look at you. So that's one of the things that are not so positive to make internship a little bit hard. And another thing is the working hours. Oh God, the working hours. As an intern in the hospital that I work in, you're required to come to hospital at 7 o'clock and finish your shift at 5 p.m. Sometimes because of the amount of work, you get to stay later. And when you're on call, so usually the calls will be around 30 hours because you start at 7 a.m. become 7 p.m. that's 12 hours, then 7 a.m. again. Then you're supposed to leave the hospital around 2 o'clock and then go rest. Next day in the morning, you come back to work. You see how many hours that has been? It's been almost 30 hours. So that's one of the things, not so good things about internship, is because it can be hard, long hours, and you can be very macerated, as they like to say. Another not so good thing about internship is that it can affect your mental state. Not that any other person cannot have their mental state affected because of a job or so, but as an intern, the workload, the isolation from everything, and also being overwhelmed by the work, you really need a strong system, people to talk to when life is hard. Sometimes you come across a death that, or it's the first time you experience a patient demising and you get into an emotional state. So you need people to communicate with, you need people to talk with, people to say, okay, I'm drowning, help me. I'm drowning, my friend, help me. You need those people, you need a support system. Or else you end up depressed and then you cannot serve your patients well, you cannot serve your community well. So to do that, you have to always have a good and open mindset. The next not so bad thing, but yeah, put it on the other side, is balancing your work and your life. So as a doctor, the hours are a lot, it's demanding, so it affects your work and love life and whatever balance. So for example, myself, I am trying to run a business successfully, I am doing this doctor thing, I'm being a freelancer, I'm trying to go into coffee. It's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. So I have to try and balance. Obviously, I have to make sure that my patients are treated well. I have to give my clients the best service ever. And it's my problem. I'm the one who's choosing to do this. So I have to find a way to balance everything. So that's one of the not so good things about being a doctor, working hours. Long working hours, I should say, and your other life, your family. Like during the internship, yeah, you feel like this is the part where everyone just has to understand that it's hard. And guys, it's really hard. Well, for me, it's hard. But it's nothing I can't handle. So I put in the work, make sure that I come out on the other side. Still sane, still doing good. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video as I was talking about my first month as a doctor. And the journey continues. I'm left with 1 month to complete my rotation in pediatrics. After this 1 month, I'm going to internal medicine and I hope it's gonna be fun. Oh God, internal medicine. But I'm gonna make the best out of it. Hope you guys have a good one and cheers till next time.